Hi students, welcome to online class. The last class we had discussed about pollination. You know now what is pollination? Yes. Today we are going to discussing agents of pollination. What agents of pollination? What is this agents of pollination means? Yes, agents. Pollination need some agents. Why the plants need the agents for pollination? Because the plant cannot able to move one place to another place, they are fixed. So how can we occur this pollination? Yes, that's right, with the help of pollinators, otherwise agents. So today we are going to discussing this agents of pollination. Okay, clear? So what is this pollination? Agents of pollination. Pollinators, thus factors help in transferring pollen grains from the anther of one flower to the stigma of another flower. This is known as what? Agents of pollination. Is it clear? Pollinating agents are called pollinators. So pollinators can be maybe abiotic, that is non-living, or biotic, that is living. Abiotic pollinators are wind and water. Water is usually used only for few aquatic plants like sea grasses, hydrilla, like that. Biotic pollinators refers to various animal species, examples mammals, reptiles, birds and insects. And insects are the most common of them. Beetles, bees, moths and birds are examples of biotic pollinating agents. Okay, so let us see the agents of pollinators, natural agents of pollination. See, first one is pollination by wind. What? Pollination by wind. And second one, pollination by water. Third one, pollination by insect. And next is pollination by animals. So these are the natural agents of pollination. I hope all of you understood this topic. Yes, thank you.